सैलरी स्ट्रक्चर इज वेरी गुड इन साइबर.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Learning Bridge. आई होप यू गाइज आर डूइंग गुड एंड स्टेइंग सेफ. पहले तो यार बहुत 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 सारा थैंक यू, बिकॉज हमारे हो गए हैं 1000 सब्सक्राइबर्स. सो उसके लिए बहुत बहुत सारा थैंक यू फॉर ऑल द लव एंड सपोर्ट. इतनी ज्यादा खुशी हो रही है ना कि बता नहीं सकता, मन कर रहा है
आकाश में जाकर फट जाऊं.
ऐसे ही सपोर्ट करते रहना क्योंकि बहुत लंबा रास्ता कवर करना है अभी. सो गाइज, टुडे सेशन इज अबाउट साइबर सिक्योरिटी एंड फॉर दिस सेशन वी हैव अवर गेस्ट कृति श्रीवास्तव. शी इज वर्किंग एज अ सिक्योरिटी प्रोग्राम मैनेजर इन पेटीएम. In this session, she has discussed about cyber security, her experience in cyber security, why cyber security is needed, types of cyber security, what is bug bounty program and how you can make money from it.
अबे जल्दी बोल, कल सुबह पनवेल निकलना है.
And what are the best practices to create a secure application? Watch this video till the end if you want to know all the basic aspects of cyber security. So without wasting time, let's jump on to the session.
Hi Kriti, thanks a lot for your time, and let's start with this session. First of all, I would like you to introduce yourself. And why did you choose in this cybersecurity domain?
Okay, hi Shashank, and thank you for inviting me here. Okay, about me, I have done my BTech in information technology, and I was campus placed with a company called Hughes Technolabs Private Limited as a software engineer. And yeah, then later on, I got an opportunity to work with Paytm, but in Paytm, I was in altogether different domain. Okay, then on my way, I got an opportunity to work in this particular domain, which is cyber security. The thing which attracts in this domain is there is unlimited growth, a practical growth. I mean, every individual want that they get experience. Along with that, their learning graph should elevate, right? So this is a particular domain where the learning is unlimited. And second of all is, I don't know if I can mention this, but the salary structure is very good in cyber security.
Hey,
so yeah,
that's a really
one of the reasons.
That's a really important point to mention, actually.
Yeah, because this domain is blooming, and it is actually getting more, this is getting more famous, and it has a very very critical impact on the organization front also. So yeah, so that is, this thing is there. Yeah,
yeah.
So the next question is, what are the types of cybersecurity?
Cybersecurity majorly it is segregated in four types. Very first is the critical infrastructure and the network security.
Okay.
So in this security, experts actually make sure that the interconnection network is secure. There is no weak point in the network site. They continue to enhance their policies and procedures to to safeguard the network side. Second is your application security. Application security majorly secure your systems from the external threat that might come on the way of the software development life cycle only. So yeah, this is the second classification. Third, I would say cloud security. Cloud computing and security is actually based on software tools, right? And the vendors itself who are providing the cloud spaces to the organization make sure that they only provide such dashboards and mechanisms. And here the security, what is the role of the security professional here? They should be very vigilant and smart to work on that particular software and should know the configuration side and to know how much important the data is. And by no chance a data should be compromised. So working on that software and making sure this thing is the key point of the security professional. And fourth is the IoT, which is Internet of Things, which is again getting very popular nowadays. Yeah. I mean, it is getting popular across the globe now. Yeah. IoT is basically the safeguarding the physical component of the organization, like the printer, the Wi-Fi, the scanners. So security professional make sure that they are behaving in a proper way. There is no abnormal behavior of the physical systems, and organization do have a wide variety of physical systems in place, right? So making sure that they are behaving in a proper way and they are giving the right output as intended, and there is no weak point, and there is no weak end point that an intruder can get into the organization or the system in any which way. So yeah, so these are the four categories of cyber security.
So what are the skill sets required to become a cyber security engineer?
See, technologies are nowadays coming and going with the snap of the finger, right? So one thing is cyber security engineer should be skilled so much and should be proactive on the technology front. The first thing is this. Second is the intrusion detection. Trojan, powerful trojans or backdoor codes always try to steal the confidential data of the organization by bypassing the security wall of authentication. So cyber security professionals should be skilled enough to make sure that this wall should not be bypassed by the attacker. So this is another skill. Third skill is malware analysis, and malware intrusion is a very serious thing. If it happens to an organization, it can actually, make loss up to millions of the organization. So this is a very serious skill and expert should have. So in this, again, they should have a skill digital threat management. They also should have knowledge about business continuity and disaster recovery planning. They should have the skill of this thing. Because, if something happens, so they should be very vigilant and very proactive in detecting the threat first of all, and then reversing it, and then getting the business up again in no time. So this is again a very important skill. Yeah. And fourth is they should have the basic understanding of the programming languages.
अबे पागल हो गया क्या?
मैं पागल हो गया हूँ. जब तक साले को जान से नहीं मार दूँगा, तब तक चैन से नहीं बैठूँगा. साले ने सारे मेरे सपने बर्बाद कर दिए.
Because that is also very important. Security testing are done on codes also. There might be possibility that tampering of the code can happen, or malicious code can be injected in the code repos itself. So this is also very important. They should have the good knowledge of understanding of the basic concepts of programming is important. And one more skill they should have is they should think like a black hat hackers, because if you want to safeguard a thing, so you should have the ability to think in that zone also. So penetration testing is one thing that can that is very helpful to achieve this objective. So and Kali Linux is the best way to to master this penetration testing skill. Along with this, they should have the understanding of the network infrastructure, system architectures, they should have a good knowledge about the web protocols also and web programming languages also. So yeah, these, if they have the basic understanding of all these things, so that person is a skilled person in this domain.
Okay, thanks Kriti for letting our users know about these basic skill sets for cybersecurity. What kind of questions are being asked in the interview process for a cybersecurity engineer role?
if we will go for any interview, there will be n number of rounds. So initially they would ask you the basic questions, basic question as in the questions related to network, very basic questions they would ask you. And then in the later rounds, they will come up with the questions based on your specialization. Specialization, I mean, see, a person cannot have the understanding of everything. So right. They would have a specialization on a particular thing. I mean, a person might have a good understanding about application, how the application is is developed and what code scripts are made, or a person is very good or a person can be very good in making developing automation scripts, right? So right. So you have to make sure when you are going for an interview that whatever is your skill, you should project that on your resume. And and the interviewer will going to question you on those things only. So this is the important thing. And one more thing which I personally think is a person should always have an attitude of projecting that they are very keen to learn new things. Yeah.
Okay.
This is also a one factor which actually plays an important role during your interviews. So wherever, whatever is your specialization, you should know that and you should project that in your resume, and you will be through the interview round for sure. You should not write unnecessary stuff to, I have the experience in this, and you actually don't know about that particular thing. So yeah,
Okay, thanks a lot, Kriti, for answering this. The next question is, what are the different roles available in the cybersecurity domain?
Different roles, as in if I talk about the roles, again, it comes to the segregation of the, of a single umbrella. There is a network security engineer, and there is the application security engineers. There are the auditors roles also. And there are people who have the knowledge of IAM. So there are IAM security professionals also. So yeah, these are the different roles and roles in the field of cybersecurity.
What are the best practices to make your application secure?
Write a secure code. The very first thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So cybersecurity professionals are always on their toes for making the set of the best secure guidelines. So developers should keep that thing in mind and then write their code. One thing. Okay. Second, use authorized APIs only, because unauthorized APIs are loosely coded, and they unintentionally, and through that unintentionally, a hacker can get the privilege and they can misuse things, right? So yeah, one is this thing. Third is adopt good cryptographic techniques. Encrypt all your data.
Okay.
Every single unit of data which is exchanged over the application should be encrypted. Third, be double sure that while using the third party libraries. So there is an instance I would like to quote here is in GNUC libraries, there was a security flaw that the attackers remotely can inject the malicious code. So yeah, so while using the libraries, third party libraries, you should be very, very sure while using, and you should test the code also. One should use the principle of least privileges, like there should be a proper categorization of privileges that admin access should be be given to these people only, and they should follow this particular thing. There should not be that there is no proper privileges defined and anybody is having the access to the to the product or the panel created.
So yeah, I'll wrap up this session with a last question, that is, like, tell our viewers about this bug bounty program and how can someone earn from it.
Okay. So, bug bounty program is actually a vulnerability reward, initiative to reward or recognize the person who has identified and reported a software bug. So I think this is a win-win situation for both, for the hackers and the company, both. Why this is a win situation for a company? The answer is that, they are able to add an extra layer of protection for their online assets. Right. And if you will ask me why this is a win-win situation for the hackers, because they have a variety of assets, online assets, and the chances where they can actually utilize their skills and get paid also if they have come up with the good vulnerability in the software or the build itself. So, okay. Yeah, and how can they earn through it? There are big companies and there are small companies also who have their bug bounty programs running. And if I have to name few organizations, Facebook, Apple, PayPal, and Paytm also is actually running their bug bounty programs. And these programs are really awesome because it's helped you to enhance your skill, first of all, and you are competing with the greatest ethical hackers we have in our country or outside, across the globe. So, right. Yeah. So this is a very good program and whoever has this, they think they have the ability to search or, they have the interest in, trying to exploit a system try to get hold of the bugs and the vulnerabilities. So this program is a very good thing for them. They should actually go for this, and they can enroll themselves. Whoever wants to, whoever have the just to get into this thing, so they can enroll themselves in Bug Crowd or HackerOne. And they have to give whenever you have, you have won a bounty. Whenever you have your reported bug is a valid bug and you get the bounty out of it. So, yeah, you have to pay a service charge to these organizations, but then again giving a small amount to doesn't mean anything if your skill is getting upgraded and you are able to detect bug in the other organization software and builds. So this itself is a good thing.
Thanks, Kruti. I mean, that was a really wonderful session on cybersecurity with you. And I hope our viewers will find it really useful because, yep, there are some entry-level freshers or working professionals who haven't that much idea about this domain. And obviously, as you said, this profile is booming nowadays. So, yep, that will be really helpful. Again, thanks a lot. Thank you very much for taking out your time for this session.
Thank you so much, Shashank, for inviting me. And I hope this is a good session for the people who are actually seeking information in this particular domain. So I hope this is helpful for them. And yeah, thank you. It was a pleasure.
So that's it for today's session, guys. I hope you guys liked the session on cybersecurity. And if you liked it, then like, share, and don't forget to subscribe the channel. And if you have any queries or concerns about this cybersecurity domain, put your questions in the comment section. And if there is any specific topic which you want me to cover in my next video, then comment that as well in the comment section. And if anybody is interested to give a tech talk on my channel, then please do reach out to us. I'll be really happy to feature you on my YouTube channel. Till then, stay safe, stay tuned.